photo, pour so photogenic. All I know is to go, go get it. Shoot my shot, and I ain't gon' miss it. All I know is to go, go get it. All my life, I've been a go get up. All I know is to go, go get it. Wake up in the morning, kiss my son, and go, go get it. Go, go get it. Go, go get it. Photo, pour so photogenic. All my life, I've been a go get up. Wake up in the morning, kiss my son, and go, go get it.
Playoff football has come to the west coast of Florida, and we are at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Washington Commanders and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. With a chance to head to Arizona in 2 weeks' time for Super Bowl 57, we are underway now at the NFC Championship. This one fielded at the 5. And he's going to be out of bounds here right at the 20-yard line. Down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up second down. On second down, they'll run with White. And not much doing there, maybe a yard up to the 23.
He's definitely tough to get down. We just saw it right there. But how about what we did see? Pursuit, wrap up, and then the big finish with the tackle.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. Brady gonna throw. It's grabbed over the middle by White. And he is gonna have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
There are a lot of tough routes to try and cover. When you see a runner come out of the backfield and run this angle route, looks like they're going to the flat, and then they put their foot in the ground and cut back sharply inside, not easily covered, and then when they catch it, good momentum built up by them as well.
And able to pick up the first. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down. Well, we know he can run the football too, but he's a good pass catcher. That's been on display here, Charles, on this opening drive.
And we certainly have seen the benefits of what he did in the offseason, which was spend more time with wide receivers, working on routes, working on cuts, in order to make himself a more complete running back and even more of a threat downfield.
Brady going to sling this out wide to Godwin. Only able to gain a couple there, and it'll be second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Brady to throw again. And his throw is incomplete.
Not a great start dropping his first target, but let's face it, it won't be his last chance because he'll get opportunities to make up for that one throughout this game.
Seventh play of the drive forthcoming on 3rd and 8. Now Brady. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home. Chase Young in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down. He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. First and 10 here for Hal and the Commanders at their own 26. Here's Gibson to start the drive. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now throwing on first down here. Pressure comes and down he goes. Levante David making his presence felt in the backfield.
The lessons will continue of this rookie. He's got to learn how to read situations just a little bit better. That far behind the line, he's got to find a way to get rid of the football and not take the sack, whether it's with his legs or just throwing it away.
Throwing on second and long. Powell. Thomas has got it. Complete. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Head coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, get your tight end and get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They'll send Brown in motion right. That's out to the flat for Gibson. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. A nice throw there. And this is a quarterback, you remember, looking to do what no other rookie has done, and that's lead his team into the Super Bowl.
And now you've made me go back down memory lane a little bit because we have had a few guys come close. Think about Patrick Mahomes in 2018. Second year in the league, but his first as a full-time starter. I go back to 2000 with the Vikings and Dante Culpepper. Also his first year as a starter. But this would be something I think would be very noteworthy.
On first and 10, it's Gibson. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Shaquille Barrett there pushing upfield to make the stop.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Now on second and 13, Powell. Looking for Thomas, but that's intercepted. And the Buccaneers are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
I think he thought he had his first read open on that one, but they were obviously ready for that throw. And that's just a lack of experience shipment. Young quarterback stared his man down the whole way, and they were more than happy to sit on that route and bring home the INT.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. Steps away to his left. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
But that was actually throwing game 101 right there. You challenge double coverage like that, you're liable to get burned. Fortunate that was just incomplete.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. They defer to White out of the shotgun. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Throwing is Brady on third down. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. Fourth down, so Jake Camardo is out there. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And this one sails out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25. It will. 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one.
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way, because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete, and then get to the running game and try and get things settled down.
Yeah, it's still in the first half here, a long way to go. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Here's Hal to throw on second down. Down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Joe Tryon able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time. No score after one on EA Sports. With an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Now they go play action with Hal. And that will be incomplete.
Two drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get on track in this one.
So on fourth down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. Taken from just outside the 30. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start out here first and 10. Chase Young, that is now two sacks for him here in this first half. But when you see a quarterback retreating away from the line of scrimmage toward the other goal line like that, usually doesn't end well.
You're exactly right about that. Normally, if they're moving from side to side, they've got a chance maybe to get back upfield. He was trying to shake defenders and extend the play, but it doesn't work out very well for them at all. You need those extra yards on the other side of the line of scrimmage. Now you're digging a hole for your offense.
On first down, Brady. He completes it to Evans. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
in need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Brady gives this to White, and he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Brady. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Tight end has become a bigger and bigger part of the passing game in the NFL, but if you drop the football, that position could get swapped out with a wide receiver in that spot, a running back in that spot. There are other ways it can go if you're not going to catch the ball.
And that's not just his first drop, his second drop of the game. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Back to throw here. This will take it in by Otten. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 24-yard line. Brady now to throw. And Evans calls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans, a 24-yard touchdown. And the Bucs have struck first in this NFC title game. Extra point put through by Succop, and it's now a 7-0 game. The Bucs ready for the kickoff, and here we go. It's in the air. Very short kick taken right at the 20, and he won't quite make it to the 25. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And he's got it inside the 10. A huge play there for Washington. 67 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
They'll run with Robinson. And he fights his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Brian Robinson, Jr. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Commanders are an extra point away from evening this one up. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
And because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. Brady to throw on second down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
And this offense on third down today, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. to throw is Brady. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down, here's White. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Myles Garrett showing that athleticism as he gets in to make the play.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
2 minutes remain in the first half of this NFC Championship. Second and 13, Brady. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. Here's Jake Camarda now. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. 51 yards on the punt there. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out. But I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
With a play fake, and now here's Hal to throw it. And his throw here is incomplete.
This is a half for not just the coverage, but the entire defense is setting the tone in this game.
Second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Powell throwing on third down here. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That third down conversion, good for 23. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
They'll go play action. Howell slings this deep for McLaurin. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, as the first half is winding down. And the Commanders have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Extra point by Sly is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now the Bucks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
I don't know whether it will be a fly on the wall or not when they hear the explanation of how he, one of the bigger targets on the field, the tight end can be that wide open and uncovered downfield. Who blew that assignment?
Somebody did.
No doubt about it. There's no way you're not going to account for him.
He completes it right side to White. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Throwing again on second down. Brady. This is caught by Evans. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So we've reached halftime here in the NFC Championship. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway in the NFC Championship game. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And I think here with the lead, CD, they have to resist that temptation of kind of looking ahead. Would you agree?
Absolutely, I would agree, because they know the stakes. They know the winner of this game goes to the Super Bowl. And this one, it's far from over. They were the better team in the first half, but they do know that they're facing their toughest opponent of the year. And they've got to be prepared for them to fight it out all the way and add a few extra wrinkles in the second half as well. They need to stay on guard.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Now he'll look to throw it. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. That's a keen hit. The tackle in the NFL. Coming in for the sack.
With fury, because they don't have to be quite as precise, and it paid off for them on that play, didn't it?
Sure did. Excellent play, really setting the tone for this third quarter. Third and long, here's Howell. Taking a shot for Samuel. And that's caught inside the 30. And he's going to get this down near the 25. We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there. Gibson here running out of the gun, and nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Here's Howell. Going to go down. Off the 37-yard line. Multiple defenders. action. It's Howell.
And this is going to be incomplete.
Maybe a little over-anxious in the pocket there. He just didn't look comfortable on that throw.
No, he didn't, because it wasn't his normal fluid delivery. And I think you might have had it right. Wasn't really confident with what he saw downfield and almost felt like he wanted to pull that one back.
Well, looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps a deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
And I would say that you pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same, because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, the kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
And a good push there defensively as they stop him at the 48. Gain of just one.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
On second and nine, Brady. Over the middle to Evans. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Looking to throw again on second down. Brady, and brought in by Brady. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 15-yard line. Into the red zone, it's Brady. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
We're in the third quarter of the NFC title game. This is second and 10. Running out of the gun with White. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. Here's Brady. And he fires one, but incomplete.
I think that's a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. Suckup's kick is good. And that will cut this lead back down to four now at 17-13. Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate in which side won, partner, because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. they're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35. One quarter remains for the right to go on to the Super Bowl. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Washington on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. Powell of the QB sneak. And he's going to have a Commanders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
There may have been a little bit of an element of surprise there. Third and inches, and they go quarterback sneak. I still feel like this is a play that often is reserved for fourth down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll try the left side with Gibson. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away, and they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
I think he had to load that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Faking the handoff, Howell. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. On the counter, Gibson. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. The center receiver in motion to the right. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. Touchdown, Washington! Terry McLaurin with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Commanders are closing in on a Super Bowl berth now as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Washington kick team back out there now as they will send this one away. Taken at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they are in need of points here, no doubt about that. With a Super Bowl berth on the line and trailing here in the fourth quarter, this possession, gigantic. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4. They'll come up second and 6 now from the 24. Here's Brady to throw. Finding Otten once more.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Brady now on first down. And Jones has it over the middle. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that he could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Again, they'll throw with Brady. He finds his target. It's Evans. And he's going to get this down near the 25. On first down, Brady. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Throwing again on second and 10. Brady. And this is caught by Evans. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
This will be play number 7 on the drive, third and a yard. Again, it's Brady. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. And the Commanders are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. A few things better than a big man interception. You can always tell right when they get the football, there's that level of excitement and nervousness and also like, what the heck do I do with this thing?
And you say, no better sight? Well, not for the quarterback who just threw it. It's bad enough to throw a pick, but throw one to the big guy? But you're right about that. Now what do I do with it? But what's fun about it is you know they're going to be in the film room after this ball game telling all their teammates, maybe I should shift over to offense. I've got skills. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I always find myself cheering for them after they intercept it. Unfortunately here, he couldn't make it into the end zone. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back, and he is going to lose yardage here. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're still on the 4-down and 12.
That's sometimes not the best play, and the defense actually has a plan as well. They're blocking it on everyone on that play. They're able to close it down and spill it for a loss.
So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a 3rd down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. On 3rd down, here's Gibson. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he gets up near the 25 to about the 24 before going out of bounds. 42 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. On 1st down, right back to Gibson. Gibson gets hit and he fumbles it. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
I'm guessing that on the sidelines there might be a few words said about that mistake there, but I don't think it's going to hurt them in the long run. They're still going to get out of it.
Yeah, they got the 2-score cushion, but you know what coaches say, Charles, finish strong.
Finish the game out the way it's supposed to be played. In fact, coaches might be secretly happy, gives them a chance to do a little extra coaching next week.
Now Brady gets away with one. Lucky, could have been intercepted, but it falls to the ground.
Now the question is obvious. Do you try to kick the field goal right here knowing that you need two scores? I would be thinking about if I were on that sideline. Get the field goal now, try and get the touchdown later.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Back to throw here. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jamin Davis, and the Commanders are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50.
Oh, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Second down and a run by Robinson. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, Carter. There's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ball game. And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. And this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where...
That's caught at the 25. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. Brady now on first down. This is caught. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
Yeah, on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Back to throw, Brady. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. So still a chance with just over 20 seconds to go, but they need to get this one back, no doubt. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
The Halas Trophy, unbelievable victory, moving on to the Super Bowl.
I only hope that these players understand exactly who is behind that trophy. George S. Halas, one of the creators of this great game of football of ours and creator of the NFL. What an amazing feeling and an amazing accomplishment.